What is it? Does it taste good? Does it like to play games? Schmigal likes to play games. Just kidding, everyone. It is me, the Hobbit 81. Welcome back to another episode of Realms. Something very interesting has happened. I've had this skin installed for ages. It was actually made for me. Off the top of my head, I can't actually remember who made it for me now. My mind is a blank. But the thing is, it's a two-layer skin. So if I, like, this is obviously Smeagol, looking awesome. My idea was to use this for PvP battles. And the thing is, it never worked. Like, if I... Cool little texture there, back of the head there. If you go into options, video settings... This video settings? So let's go past it. Skin customization right there. Sleeves on. Hat. Right, that, like that. And there I am. Even though these have all been turned to on for ages, it never worked. I was always just Bilbo Baggins. But yeah, when I was getting ready to record this episode, I'm like, hey, it works. Maybe because I updated 1.9.4. I don't know. But that is excellent. That's going to be very useful for recording and for basically freaking people out. Yes, so as I said, welcome back. I've just changed my hand, haven't I? That's creepy. Main hand, right. There we go. All is good now. Those sounds a little bit loud in my headset. I'm just going to turn down some of the sounds a bit. There we go. I'm very excited for today's episode. I hope you are too. I'm excited because I've got lots of things to show you, lots of projects to work on, some updates on a few things, and Bambi's been working on something over at Site B for me. I haven't seen it yet, but I am very excited to find out what it is. I did tell him about my plans for the library, and I think it may be relating to that. But first of all, I wanted to show this little guy over here that I've been working on. I haven't quite come up with a name yet, but this is going to be, when it's finished, the random project generator. And before I show you the redstone, the concept is I'll be able to push a button, get a random book, which will tell me what project I should work on. I've got this design from someone else. The name will be up on the screen at the moment, and a link to the description will be there for you to check out. I have done it slightly different. They did it in a way where there was multiple chest cards here, and every time you log off and on again, you would be able to click a different one. I've done it slightly differently because I wanted many, many options. It won't look as good because the book will always be in the top left-hand corner. They had it in the middle, which looked quite nice, obviously. But I wanted to have it to be a bit different. So I'm a stand in a minecart and another minecart with a chest card in it. And if we open it up, a bit of an odd hitbox on it. At the moment, there's coal on there. There's no books. Oh yeah, but I'm armor back on too. I've got to make the books. I've got all the books ready, but then I remembered, you need ink and feathers too. Now please, 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 redstone people, excuse the redstone. At the moment, there's a button just over here, which activates a... Let me think for a second. It's a reversed or inverted signal. It comes over here. It unpowers this first, which allows the item in the hopper minecart to flow into the currently locked hopper here. I just said hopper minecart, didn't I? Chest minecart, which then flows into this pair of droppers, which push the items up here. This one's on a 1 tick delay, and that's on a two tick delay. And that pumps it back up into there, and then that pumps it back straight into the chest. So the idea is you push the button once, and it releases one item first, and then puts a new item in there. At the moment, I've just put some random assortment of items just for testing purposes. Also, the redstone signal also comes over here, gets inverted again. I know this is messy, and there's probably a much, much better way to do it. And this one just actually turns off this one here. So when you push the button, and eventually there'll be either a pressure pad here or a button over here you better press. So coal's in there at the moment. Push it once. And that should be good. And then we can open it again. And now there's cobblestone in there. So that would represent a different book. And there was an arrow in there. So I'm really, really happy that that worked. That's quite good for me for redstone. Obviously, I know how to tidy this up. It was all just pretty much testing for now. We've got the books over here, ready to go. But like I said, I need to get some more feathers and ink sacs. Now, squids have started spawning again in my area, which is good, so that won't be a problem. I'll probably get to that later. I've got about 24 different projects that I want to work on, either start or continue. So start of next episode, we'll have a look at what they are. I've been really going hard with the mushrooms there to get the leather I need for the books. I really need some better swords to start. The problem is my XP farm at the moment is only the Dark Pagoda one, which is not the best for XP. It's more of a resource grinder. Oh, I wanted to show you this too in a second. I am actually trying something at the moment, which we'll check out in terms of trying to make it a bit more automated. I'm doing some testing at the moment. Isles has been doing some work as well. I've still got a cat and a pair of cats. I think a pair of cats, a pair of dogs, and some villagers in there. I have my little rooftop garden up here for their base. Well, that's their base, one of their bases there. They beautify this area a bit. So we've got this dark, menacing pagoda and a lovely little garden. And I swear this thing looks like some sort of teleportation device. I'm expecting to trigger something when I come here. Nope, that's okay. I've currently got water animations turned off. Actually, I don't know if I do anymore because I'm running the latest version of Optifine. Video settings, animations. Let's go all on. Terrain off. I don't dripping water off. Water animation. Water particles off. That's fine. Was the water animation went there? Turn that off as well. It helps in the Dark Pagoda because of all the water and the updates. This thing's all still working fine. I'm pretty sure everyone's still here. We've got cat there, the dog there. How do we get up again? The villager should still be there. Yep. I added extra protection. There's an extra layer of carpet there. And down they go. Yep. Sometimes the zombies go down the wrong slot. I'm not too fast with that. The main one is that the creepers get sorted. That's for the main project once again for the oh, spiders. No. That's all right. The main project, which would be the giant brewing machine. All right. So I was trying to make a little bit of a thing here, and having a little bit of trouble. All right, they're loud. Music and sounds, hostile creatures. Try that. So I needed some furnaces just for now. I brought some copper with me. We're gonna make two more. One, two. This is all just testing at the moment. I'm actually probably gonna have it so that they get moved out of here. Oops. Ah, come on. Really? This will prevent the sticky pistons from grabbing the glass. The sticky pistons, the slime blocks. Can I not place that there? Maybe the heads are in the way. Yeah, probably. Alright, so slime blocks ready. These are from my little slime farm over near the main pagoda. Let me think for a second how I want to actually do this. That's gotten stuck on this slime block, hasn't it? That didn't almost work, but no, I want to cause myself problems here. Oh. I probably should have shut the thing off first. Oh, don't put me in there. No. Whoa, 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 wait, wait. Hey, no, wait. Bad zombies. Take that back. Right. Doing all right. We're okay now. It's still very loud though. I think. Definitely turn it down for this section then. Alright, and we'll put a slime block here. And the other furnace up there. And here. So what I'm thinking is we might actually funnel them out of there, or have the option to funnel them out. I was also thinking I was, might be able to lower this a little bit. There's a lot of redstone under there. And it all comes up pretty high. But we might be able to funnel them out. I can use water and then push them into a crushing machine. I just wanted to do some tests. So if you turn it on, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh, that's interesting. Was not quite expecting that. Why are they doing that? All right, how many hits are they now? Am I not able to reach him? Seems odd that I wouldn't be able to reach him. Just in the corner there. Alright, let's try this. Unfortunately, it's like this setup here is not very aesthetically pleasing, so I want to move them out. Work better, but that's not too bad. That's takes them down quite a bit of damage, actually. That's weird though. Why is it pulling them out? I'm sure there's some good reason for that. If anyone knows in the comments, oh, this is also pulling that out. Look at that. Just leave that off. What about over here? Yeah, we've done it over here too. That's okay. That's good. That's good. That's still all just testing stuff. That's all right. A lot of stuff over here I do need to take with us for the next part of the episode. I made a heap of bows. They should be all in here. Yeah, I was making some extra dispensers to take with us. So I'm not sure how many I'll need, but I'm gonna make a few. I did pick them a couple, didn't I? Like this. The for the next part of the episode, we will be going over to the lovely site B. Check out what's going on over there. Oh, wait, I know I need to do the redstone again. And I must admit, the next part of the video I'm actually quite nervous about because it's. Oh, do you hear that? That actually sounded like the. A villager, but I think it was actually the witch then. Yeah, so I'm a bit nervous about the next part of the video because I'm going to be doing some sort of experimental redstone. For me, and like I've already said, redstone is not my thing, and what I'm going to be making is not based off anything else. Like, often I'll find someone else's thing that they've made and I'll modify it and use it for myself. This is sort of going to be an original project. All right, we're back over on site B now. And did you see those witches? I didn't even think of that. Like, suffocation. Trying to do that for a witch. They just use potions of, I guess, water breathing to prevent them from suffocating. So I had never even considered that. That's interesting. Might have to use something else to kill them. Look at all the iron. I've been AFKing here as much as possible. Hiding out a little hole over here. I mean, I know it is a mushroom island, but better to be safe than utterly destroyed. Look, yes. That is beautiful. Means this thing's working very well. I am thinking about putting another ring on it, having it up in the sky, and potentially you could also put one down if you can get down far enough. I'm not sure, I have to check the numbers. If it's 100, 127 blocks away, I think it has to be, or something like that. So I could easily put one in the sky and just have the iron golems fall. Would there need to be a water break, perhaps? That wouldn't be too hard to install. And yeah, beautiful. We had another one. We have more iron than we could ever use for this fireball series. Beautiful. I want to show you what I've been working on over here. I've added in some little stalls here. We've got a leather worker down the end, a butcher, armorer. Did I spell that right? Armorer. Mora, I'm not sure. A weaponsmith, and what's this one? Toolsmith. I tried to put them in order of sort of most important to least important. Sorry, leather worker, but that's the way it is. I've got Kiba's little ender pearl dispenser here, very handy. Over here, I'm going to set up shops for farmers, shepherds, fishermen, farmers, and Fletcher. A farmer is potentially more important than some of the other ones, but that's okay. I can always change those around if I want to. I'm trying to think. Like, I'll show you in a minute, but I've got so many villagers up there. It's not even funny what I'm gonna be able to do with them all. I think a lot of them are actually going to get disposed of. Don't tell them. I've also set up a bit of a path here. You can see some ladders there. And what I wanted to work on today was moving the villagers out of there to different locations. Not just out of there, but actually, I've been thinking about this many different ways. I want some to come down here, and I want some to come to the library, which is going to be put around the back. Did I show you that in the last video? I don't know if I did or not. And some of them will also go, I'm trying to think, library, to the areas here. Anywhere else? I think that's about it. And I suppose I could also set up like a place where people could come and buy them, push them through the portal or something. So maybe an extra spot for ones that are half decent, but I'm not going to need, and I could sell them to other people. I could give them away, I suppose, but where's the fun in that? And we're only going to need a couple of farmers for the farm areas over there, so that doesn't need to be hooked up with a permanent thing. So what I was going to do was run around in circles. Come over here. I'll show you this. And also, I just noticed up there, Bambi's added some supports underneath that. It's not bad. It's not bad. Whoops, it's a mushroom block. I quite like that. I still don't know if it'd be strong enough to hold that up. We might actually upgrade that to walls. Might look good up there. So we come up here. Where was it? Further up. Yeah. So I made a path here. On this end of it, I've got a sharp drop and an area here. My plan is that up there you'll be able to select a button and you'll send villagers down to this area. So to the, I had a name for this, the square, you know, like a plaza or the name will come to me in a minute. And they'll come down here and they'll drop down into a minecart Pez dispenser. And then at the bottom, you'll have a item selector. I might put it into the wall or around the corner a bit. And you'll say, okay, well, this one's a leather worker. So you push the leather worker button. You'll have eight different buttons, I think. One, two, three, four, five, eight, nine buttons. Or maybe one of those nice dial selectors that you can do with the item frame. And then you push a button and it'll send them over to here. Now, if you've got sort of two options, you can either get just a single one, which is the best that you can possibly get, or you can get several that are pretty good. Sometimes you'll get one that's better with like leather worker is probably not the best example because I don't know if I've ever even used a leather worker before. But let's say you have a cleric. Oh, that's what I need to do. Did I make a place for clerics? Armorer, weaponsmith. Ooh, so we need somewhere to store clerics. Okay, I'll have a think about that one. But for a cleric, like sometimes you get really good trades on the zombie flesh, but not for something else. Or on a farm, you might get really good pumpkin trades, but not for carrots. So what I was thinking of doing is for each one of these, setting up a villager swapper. If I can work out one that does it while they're still in the minecart, I think that'd work best for me. But barring that, I would have to do it where they actually get out the minecart and then you swap them around. They're pretty easy to make, pretty well made, pretty well tutorialized on the internet. So you come over here and you'd push the button and you'd be able to change to all the different leather workers. So that's the plan, and that's why I'm also nervous because the idea I have for sorting them up there, I've never done before, and I've started doing it on Gen X, so this is sort of both series are going to work together in terms of how you sort things out. Let's go up to the top and I'll show you what I mean about how many villages I have. Yep, there it is. Up, 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 up. If you're wondering about my elytra wings, I currently have them stored back on the main island. I want to not use them again until I've got mending, which I'm hoping to get soon from the librarians. All right, so yeah. Why is there a random bookcase there? Because I needed it to sort of jump to get out. And I was doing some trading with some of the librarians to try and find the one with mending. So this is working pretty good. One of my plan is to put down a bucket of water, push them all down into the corner and fence them off, and then build some rail system here. And underneath where they're sort of hanging out, we'll put a dispenser with a minecart, and you'll push the button. And we'll pick one up. There'll be some sort of system that keeps one constantly loaded, perhaps. And then you'll have a selector panel to either send them to wherever we're going to send the clerks to. Clerics. Oh my god, English today. One for the library. I'm really having a fantastic English day today. And then one for the other area down there. And the name still has not come to me, but town square, something like that, you know. Marketplace. The words, they are coming back to me. Huzzah. Anything else up here to show you? I don't think. My plan for the lobby was around the back and whoop. Oh yeah. Bambi has been doing some work. Let's not spoil it. Let's go down and have a look. Normally I would glide around with my lovely wings, but never mind. Let's just shoot an enderpearl down. Whee! I'm here. So I told him I wanted it around the back here, and he's been doing some work. As usual. Look at this. Nice path. Are they stairs? They are. Oh yeah, they actually stick out a little bit like that. And here we go, big reveal. Oh, look at that. Look at that. I was talked about using diorite to build it, but looking at that now, I like that. Look at that. It's very tall. Wow, that's even taller than I was planning to go. I suppose we've got the whole mountainside here. Oh yeah, cool. So what's he got? You've got the nether brick fences. I like the way they sort of don't really connect, but do connect to the stairs. That's cool. That way. Okay. Yep. Got some redstone lamps in there. I like it. I like it a lot. This guy's a little bit out of place. The windows, glass panes, sea lanterns. Oh, nice. Very nice indeed. Thank you very much, Bambi. That's awesome. So my plan is to sort of take this as far back as we can. We'll probably run into the stairs pretty quickly, the stairs that lead up. I would like to keep the stairs because I like to be able to get up and down different ways. A bit further than I thought. Okay, how far? Whoop. Ah, that's the bottom of the stairs there. Ah. That'd be a fun little back way to get into it, wouldn't it? I'm going to leave that like that for now. Very handy. I like that. So yeah, I'm going to hollow out as much of the mountain as I can and have a very sort of vertical library, and then have all the best librarians that I can find in there. And I've still got to also set up an item transport thing, like once we get the automatic farm set up with the villages and also just the general ones, to have, for example, the sugarcane get shipped over to the library so you can stand there, craft the paper and do the trades without having to run all over the place. Now, I have been talking a lot during this episode and not actually doing much, so I'm going to try and get started on the sorting system up there, and then we'll come back and I'll show you once I've got something interesting to show you. The horror. I had forgotten completely that lightning strikes can turn normal villagers into witches. And I just lost like a decent chunk of my population of village, and I've died as well. Oh, but the keep inventory seems to be on. Dang it, that's right, I left that on for testing purposes. Game rule. Keep inventory false. Also, I just realized that I have been recording with my old monitor settings, and I am very sorry about that. I'm going to do my best to try and make the video stretched and watchable. I'm sure it's not raining over here, is it? Man. Bed, that's what I was looking for. No bed over on the island, apparently. Alright, I'm going to get back to work. Alright, welcome back. Fortunately, when I got back here, all the witches had despawned. And I'm very sorry about having that other game mode thing set, the game rule, about keep inventory. It was on for some testing purposes, and I forgot to turn it off. Also made sure that fire spread is also turned on, just to make this the most survival-like experience. Now, I've almost got all these guys pushed into one area, but obviously because they push each other, some of that is a bit tricky. Did that last guy get in? I think he did, yep. Had a guy running around, so just put some blocks down, and he decided to run in himself. Had a bit of a wall going on. I really want everyone sort of past this point, shoved into there. Maybe I can, if I remove that wall. One of them actually went up here and he almost made it out. Then he sort of decided to do a little turn and fall down. It was quite funny. Let's see. Alright, so ladders I did not bring, but that's okay. Let's just jump in here. Manipulate the water a bit more. Well, at least try to. There's still some rogue water over here that I need to get rid of. That'll help as well. Get rid of bookcase. Having little holes here doesn't help. Let me see. Definitely making progress here. Take that away. Put one here and one here. Take it away from here. I'm also probably didn't bring quite enough blocks. Let's seal this off a bit. Maybe if we put here, I can take these back now, can't I? So let's just collect a bit of stuff to use. If I block that off, it should change the water flow a bit. How you guys doing, hey? Hey? You guys want to go over there a bit more? I don't think so. Anyway, we've got them mostly over there. Once we start thinning them out a bit, we should be alright. I really wanted to collect just one for an experiment I wanted to do. Just trying to think the best way to do it. I've got my dispensers. I've got a couple of mine carts. Easiest way seems to be put them on top of a dispenser with a rail on top of it. So if I can do this carefully without letting them out. So I can put a block there. No, not a block, I actually want a dispenser there. Dispenser. Now I can't click it because they're all in the way. What if I actually remove all the water now? I don't think they can escape at the moment. Solid there, yes. How much water is now left in there? Whoops. Probably hard to tell how much water is now left. Can I push them out of there? Tell you what, working with villagers has never been easy, but my golly, they're making it hard. Trying to get an easy way just to get one of them out. Sort of need to get rid of all of that water. Alright, let's get in and get rid of the water. Then we'll see what's what. Whoa, that's hard on the eyes. Oh, there's actually a way out here. Whoops, better fix that up. And get rid of those two. Right, is that all the water gone? Nope. Oh yes, that's some other water. Alrighty. Jump. If everyone would kindly move away from the exit. They're all crowding towards it, they know. I also could float up here. I don't want that. Nope. Oh no. There we go. Alright, well this isn't going to happen. That's just not going to happen like that, is it? What if I was to... I want to be really careful because one wrong move and I'm going to have an absolute stampede of villagers here. Is he drowning? Where is that water actually? No, I said put the water down. And pick it up. There we go. Half slabs are set. If I put... Are you kidding me? I can't put it there. Fine. Alright. Fine, I'll do the test myself then. The test was... When you come up to the top here, the idea is that it pushes you off down to the bottom there and there's a slime block there. And then you land on it safely, move around, and then once you add a cactus to it, it should... Oh, that's not going to work, it's activated rail. Dang it. It should prevent fall damage, and cactus will break the cart after the thing ejects you. So this is either going to work or it's going to kill me. Flying, flying, falling. Ooh, that did not work as expected. An entity in a mine cart has a different speed. Right, wow. Okay. I'm amazed that I survived that one. So that needs taking back perhaps 2 blocks. Yikes. Oh, well, it's all fine-tuning. It's all part of the experiment process. Back up again. Whoa. Technicolored. Also, I now know that I need to watch out if there's a lightning storm. I need to just not be here. All right, we're back. With what's left of my sanity after doing so much work here, I've employed Kiba to come along and help push buttons for me. Hello, Kiba.
Hello.
Also wanted to show off my little elevator here. I've been doing quite a bit of work on it. I spent
Ooh, looks dangerous.
Yes, that's me. I spent an entire evening getting this whole section here to work. So if you hop in the cart, if you push the button, hop in the cart, and then don't exit the cart, and you should be all right. Just don't get out. Just stay in it. Nope.
Okay. Well, that's very interesting.
Yeah. And a kick shout at the bottom because actually is that one at the top? One of them should be activator L. That's activator, that's activator. They're actually they're all
That is
activator.
act. So it kicks you when you hit there.
Yeah. You landed on this
That'd be
block.
interesting. Yeah.
But sometimes it puts you sort of here. So I'm still sort of working on making a nice little exit area here, but yeah, it works.
It'd be cool if you could actually make a whole piston system that goes up there that pushes the player into the safe area.
Yeah, that did work
You
too.
know what?
Yeah, once you arrive, it then pushes you out. Because you all you'd need
Or
is a
pulls you
defector
out.
rail. It pulls you out. Oh yeah, put a piston. Oh, I like your thinking. All right, so we're gonna go up this time. At the top, you got to get out. There's a way I can make it automatic. Here we go. I'll just drop out. Yours will be automatic because I'll just flick the switch for you, which will kick you out the cart. Are you coming up? Here he comes. There we go. So there's also an activator rail here, which has a lever on it. Because if you, I mean,
Epic.
because you don't want it normally. Well, this was for testing. Normally, you'd want it to always kick you out. Because you wouldn't want to come up here just because you want to come down again. And then I'm going to make a separate way to join on and go down again, or dispenser or something. If you get on here and push it, you'll go down and it works fine as well.
I love literatures.
I would recommend before we go in there to turn your friendly mob sounds down.
Let me let them out.
No, God, no. Please don't. Oh, dear.
Just don't make sure you don't push Q around your villagers with armor because they can pick it up.
I've seen that. I saw that somewhere. They can pick up armor and
Your
tools or something?
sharpness.
What the heck?
They can pick sharpness armor so you can actually hit a villager and die from sharpness.
Sharpness or thorns?
You can die with forms, I mean, and a villager can kill you.
Oh, God. All right, so if you want to just hop in here for a sec, please. Help me with the testing, because
Oh, where are you at?
there's this little hole right here.
Oh. This brings me
Oh,
nightmares.
yeah. It's this is a horror scenario.
Hobbit, you got more of them.
Yes, they keep breeding
Evil.
and they keep dropping down. I'm just gonna fix this guy up first. I'm just gonna go behind him. So this is not quite finished yet, but I've done the hardest parts of it are now done.
Oh, Hobbit,
Go the
you
other way.
forgot the 1.9 mechanics.
Yep, gotta shift and move him this way. Come on.
He's
He's good.
spazzing.
He's good. All right, so. We've got some explaining to
He's
do.
a.
That's fine. He's fine. He's all good. He's not dead. Totally not dead. I'll show you in a minute. I just need to make a few more ladders. I remember that I moved some ladders and then I realized I couldn't get back up to the top of the system. So I'm gonna quickly make some ladders. Hey, ladders. I shouldn't steal that. It's not mine. That's kind of happening. Every time I hear ladders, I think of it. I think the best way to get up would be possibly. I had ways to get up, but then I added more redstone wiring and now I can't get back up again, not easily. Up here.
Well, you can do.
I'll make a better way
It's weird
later.
how Minecraft changed over the years
Well, it
and
certainly
how people
has.
how the community changed it so much.
Where do we get in? I'm trying to remember where we get in now. Yeah, here we go. Over here. Here's the ladder. Watch your step as per usual. Okay, so if you come down the bottom of this ladder, extra one there. I'll try and explain some of this mad creation that I've made. That villager, when
Rest
we,
on spaghetti monster.
yeah, pretty much that villager, when we pushed him around, he came along this track. Okay. Now the way it's going to work is I'm going to push a minecart down to here. There's a door down there, so the villagers should try and go through it. A minecart will come and pick them up. There's only going to be a certain number of minecarts in the system. I think five is the number that works best. Right, so it's going to pick them up. They're going to come along this track here. They're going to hit this piston elevator, which works the same as the one we just came up, and that takes them up to the top. So we'll go up to the top next. We'll follow the path.
Yeah, they should keep this bug in here for one
Oh.
reason, because it makes everything so compact now.
God, yes. Now, whoops, can we go up this way? All my ladders are
Man.
quite dangerous. So that this to
No, it's
redstone
not.
torch here is part of the redstone torch that brings the villagers up here. I've piggybacked off it, inverted a signal, and then it just pushes the piston just to help. Once they get up here, it pushes them onto the rail down there. Okay, and you actually see the villager down there. Now I think if we come over this way, yep, this is safe over, well, safe as I get over here, and then come over here a bit. Kib's lost. Nope, he's good. He goes, oh, that works too. Kib's got two melons. Very nice. Right, step over this way for a second, please, towards the glass column. While you're bashing up your melons. Over there. That's it. So over here, this redstone spaghetti is a redstone tower. I've learnt the torch towers are not great for lag, so I'm trying to avoid using them and trying to experiment with different ways of using redstone. There's a button down the bottom which fires a quick pulse through this thing here. That's very annoying. Should we test the PVPs being left on? It fires a quick pulse and it sets off all the pistons going up here. It retracts them all, not at once, but pretty close to it, and it lets the villager down one block, one section at a time.
How about I'm a villager now?
That's fine. You can. I'm coming down there anyway, so it lets him down only just one block, and I have tested that it works. Trying to think. It's like a Pez dispenser, but I've kind of gone for my own design here. It can hold about five villagers. One, two, three, four, five. Ish, and then the last one will come along here. Do you have any ender pearls on you?
You want to break this or?
No, God, no, that's got redstone on it.
Okay,
There for a reason.
okay.
Here's a couple
Ender
of. Oh,
pearl.
you got some. So just ender pearl through. So when they get to the bottom, they get shot along here and out to here, and they'll stop here. They can't move anywhere this way. We'll go through there in a second. There's. Slowly bouncing up and down there. Whatever you're doing there looks creepy. We can actually get it this way, over here. There's a way out. Just to explain what's going on here, there's a button which does two things. At the moment, the redstone here is not finished, as most of it, but it powers the powered rail here, which will move them along, and it also retracts this block here, and it also calls the next minecart. So there's three things. I said two, but it does three things. So when I push the button, it drops the next minecart down, which will come out to here. At the same time, if there's one here, it'll send it off along this path, which we're going to talk about next. This is the next bit of redstone that I managed to work out. Underneath each of these tracks here, every second one, there's a redstone torch. When you power one of these, it'll send the minecart down that track. So at the moment, it's set to go back around the start. But if we activate this one, it'll put them in here instead. So the idea is I will be able to stand here, call a villager, and then I'll make a better selection panel. I'm not sure how I'm going to do the selection panel just yet.
I sign.
I might use the item frame.
That's what I'm saying, iron frame.
But there's only four selections, so
No, there's actually more than four.
well, there's only four here that I have that I need, I think. So the first one would go, for example, to the library, and the second one would go to the market down the bottom. The third one would go to, did I just break that? No, I didn't. The third one would go to the wherever the priests are going to go. Or there might be more. This one would, at the moment, goes back around. It's a return loop. This one might go to the farm, but I'm only going to need, pardon me, a few villagers at the farm, so I probably won't need that. Let's try this again. Science would help here.
Like a whole bunch of ants.
That's, yeah,
Ants.
it's creepy, isn't it? If you move too close to them, they start trying to sort of get to you. They seem to know that you can get them out. So let's just try this again. So the first one would go to the library. So if you get a librarian, you can send them that way. The next one would be to the market. So if you get any of the other ones, the butchers, the farmers, the toolsmiths and stuff, my keeper was having a mosh down there. You could send them down there. And the next one would be to wherever the priests go. And then the last one is going to be a moon door. And if you watch Game of Thrones, you'll know what that is. But basically, it's going to exterminate the villager. So if it's one you don't want, you can kick him off down a mighty drop.
You don't have
And
the
then we
rare
can.
villager.
I don't have the what villager?
The farmer.
There's a few farmers in there.
There's flexors, fishers.
That guy over there. Against the wall. Yep, there, right there. What's he?
That's a flexor.
Fletcher. Okay, well, that would work still. He would work at
No,
all.
I'm talking about for emeralds.
Ah, right, a literal farmer. Right. He would.
It's so rare.
Yeah. Well, with this system, we should get plenty. I've got to do some. I've done
Yeah.
some tidying up at the top there. I can't remember if I showed that, but I just made the water streams work a bit better. I think I discussed it, but I haven't shown it yet. But there's nothing too fancy worth showing off. I just made the water streams better. So that's good. So, what's next for me? And I'll do this before the next episode because I want to finally get this episode out. I've been working on it for ages. Is work out the selection panel. And I also want to test this before we go, but I'll work out the selector panel and I'll also set up the connections to the different places as well. I was thinking we might be able to set up a thing behind here to store the priests, but I don't like that idea in the end. I've got to find somewhere else. Think of some sort of building to store the priests in. Work out how many of them I might want. And also set up the, I call them the armor swappers. It's those same thing you can use for villagers. You push a button and it rotates between several. So for each one villager type, we can have multiple in the same sort of location. So like five butchers, for example.
It's so
Or the way they sprint around. They know there's a door there and it's nighttime, so they're freaking out. What was really freaky was before when I was recording, it was raining. Actually, I wasn't recording. It was raining and the lightning struck and like five or six of them all turned into witches at once.
Yeah, you didn't know that?
I'd
They
forgot.
just get
It's
turned to
something that I
witches.
did know, but I'd forgotten a long time ago.
Yeah, that happened, I think, in 1.8.
Right. So when this is finished, the glass will come off as well, and there'll be an area here where they can't escape from, and the track will run into that area and out again, you know, via having some glass blocks around and the
You should put a boat in here.
a boat. Yeah, let them play around in the boat. So there will also be a return track. And I gotta still think, like if I send a villager off to the library, I need the cart to come back. If I send two librarians off in close succession, then that's gonna cause problems. So I've still gotta think about that part, whether or not I get them to exit up here, but I hate using activate rail to get villagers to exit where you want them to, because they never go where you want them to do. If I could work
No.
that out, then I could get them to exit up here and send a cart down to pick up the next villager. Now, what I want to test, Kiva, is this button over here on the wood. Okay. You actually get
Yes.
the easy job. You get to just push the button when I ask you nicely, and after five presses,
That's great.
I should pop out.
That's great.
Glorified button pusher. All right, I'm getting in my cart because I need to test if this does damage to them. I don't hear the my cart.
Tell me to push it.
All right. You know what? I've already goofed up because the villagers are already in there. Hey, can you push the button, please?
Okay. Pushed.
Here he goes. All right, one second. All right,
I
push it again, please.
apologize. Don't blame me.
Okay, no damage.
Yeah,
Screen
block popped out of here.
popped out.
Yeah, block popped out.
What do you mean?
Was it piston?
That's fine, that's fine. Push it again. Okay, lovely, and again. Okay, here comes the villager. Okay, so you can select the path for the villager.
And he took damage.
He did? Is he still taking damage?
He went through the full block.
The one that's attached to a sticky piston?
Yeah.
Oh, okay, he's not supposed to. Okay, push the button again, please. Or you can select the path if you want to, for the villager to go to. And here we come. Hello? Hello? So, was it this block here in front of my face that he got damaged by?
Yeah.
He shouldn't, though. Yeah. Like, he must have been...
It's a...
Okay.
It's a full block of it.
Yeah, I know, but... My reasoning was that...
Wait. Hobbit, we can... Wait, no, the update prevents that. We could use a bomb block now. Well, we can't anymore because it's a solid block now. The bomb block.
Oh, well. Let me think for a second. See, look, that's a powered rail.
Mm-hmm.
But you can still get traction on it. That's mm-hmm. weird. Like, if it's not powered, you shouldn't really be able to move on it, should you?
You still get some power on it. It doesn't stop it fully. That's why you need multiple power tracks to stop somebody.
Right. Okay. Well, I'll give that some thought. It might just have to be... I mean, if I put a non-solid block there, he's just going to pass through it. So that was the whole point of that. I don't know if a slime block there would work better, if it would help bounce him back or not. But I'll do some testing, and we'll try and work that out. And it is raining, so I'm scared for a lightning strike at the moment.
Yes, and the four horsemen.
Well, more so just a whole gaggle of witches.
Plus the annoying sounds they make.
Oh yeah, they've gotten very freaky now. They're friendly and ambient up a little bit. Weather's on a little bit. Can you hear it a little bit? Hostiles need to go back up again. I was at the mob farm, so I turned that down. Players, what?
That mob farm is so crazy.
It's going to get better soon. I'm going to try and add an auto-killing thing. Let's see, particularly now we've got the magma blocks as well. Definite potential there.
Do you know they changed the rain sound?
It sounds a bit more natural.
Yes, they changed it.
So we'll have a think about this and see if there's a different way to do this, that where they can't pass through that block. But going down the tower, I didn't take any damage. I took one tick of damage going through the block, but normally what happens is... I'll show you actually here. Other way. No, go back.
Oh.
Never mind. Hang on. Let me just go up here and should get you back again. All right, so I should just stop here. I shouldn't try and move. But if Keeper then pushes the button, please. Pushes
button. When the villager went through it, he went through the block and took damage.
Yes. But that's because he was trying to go through it. He tried to move the cart and obviously it worked. Maybe.
How about I try it?
Yeah, you can try it if you like. Here's a minecart if you need one. If you put it just on top of this one here. Oh, you can do it from if you want to do it from inside the easy way, yeah, you can. I thought you go through the whole system, but you can just place it down there. Or through the gap there.
Okay. I got it. Okay.
Just through the gap. You go down to the end and come back. See if I've got any slime blocks. I think I use my slime blocks.
Okay, so you have to actually force this. The villager forced it.
And they do. They still can push quite a bit. What if I put two powered rails here? I had one.
It might work.
I just had one in my inventory. I'm going mad. Oh, it's right here. That's an activator rail, isn't it? Oh, shush. My dog's barking outside. All right, I'll try it this time.
A big guinea pig.
Okay, there you go.
Yeah. Okay, yep. Thank you for the card.
I'm trying to work out as a way to prevent you from being able to go through that block. That's pretty much what I'm trying to work out. You should only go through that when it's... If you push that way. Yep, see? I mean, when I was doing testing, that one villager, he only went through occasionally.
It's actually a way to do it, maybe.
It's a solid block. It's a transparent block. It'll be even easier for them.
If you if there's a way if you can actually get them if you can cattle them, but that's pretty much impossible by using gates. But you have to be out of the minecart to do that.
Okay. So the gate wouldn't stop them either.
The gate will stop them, but you have to actually, but you can't be in the minecart.
What if it wasn't a full block? What if it was like a wall or something? Would that make any difference? What have I got to make a wall out of some cobble? I don't know why that would make a difference, but hello, computer. There we go.
I got a wall right here. I can do
Oh,
this.
okay. Now you tell me.
I made a whole bunch of walls.
Now you tell me.
Okay.
I don't think this is going to work, but hey. Okay, you can move through it. Yep. But he didn't take any damage.
No, because it's a clear block.
God. This it actually undoes. It pulls it too. Okay. Well, we'll have a think about this, and if anyone has any suggestions, do put them in the comments in the down
Yes.
under section. I really can't think what else. I mean, maybe a slime block. I don't know if that would bounce them backwards instead.
We need some Ifo's magic.
A piston facing. No. Down with a clear block. Would that trap them in place or not? Like
Wait,
if there was a
wait,
piston.
wait, wait. Okay, wait, 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 wait. Oh, this might work. Ooh, this might work. Okay. Okay, let's just do a simple test. Do you have any redstone on you, Hobbit?
I got some in the chest over here, I think. I put a lot away. I've got the
Okay, I need some redstone.
world's clearest inventory in terms of for
Okay,
me.
activate the piston. Activate the
Whoops, I
piston.
had to push you instead. Okay, one
No.
second. I'll make one of these, and I'll make a lever as well.
Okay.
Lever. All six of them, by the way. Okay, activate the redstone piston.
Yep. And then deactivate it. Okay.
Are you
So
thinking of?
it does pull me one line card. It does pull me.
Yes,
Does it?
it did, but not through it. I suppose there's no block behind it, is there?
Let's just do a simple.
I'm seeing what you're getting at.
Yes. I mean, different craft tables. It's
Whatever
coming
works.
up.
Oops. Need some more rail. We've got some normal rail here. All right. So if I remove the crafting table now, and I put a switch over there, should do.
You.
And then back. Doesn't pull you through the other side though. Can you pass? Can you actually? Hang on, here's something. I can pass through it. Okay. Dang it.
Are you still recording
Foiled.
or not?
Yeah, I'm still recording. I've been foiled though.
No. Ah, dumb villagers.
Smart villagers. I think it's the problem here.
They're for determination.
I mean, that doesn't happen too often. They don't always try and push through it. And if you're standing here,
I've only tried again.
well, if you're standing here though, they should be more interested in talking to you than trying to escape. So let's push him. Hang on, which one is activated? One. We want this one. So I need some sort of selector that will only do one, not others. So maybe that other one would work.
Might have to speed this up.
I'm just going to cut some of it,
There
I
you go.
think.
Too.
All
Yeah.
right. What just activated then? Two, three, four. So that one on the next one. There we go. Okay, so if you're
Okay, this
standing
time
there,
he did it.
yeah, because he wants to talk to you. Because you're standing there. So that the AI says, there's a person, he's looking at me, I think. No?
Ooh, he actually has a decent trade.
Yeah?
Sweet. 39 rotten flesh for
Ooh,
emerald.
nice. So he might be worth keeping. So the idea would be then you would go, okay, he's a cleric, so you want to flick the third switch, but only the third switch. And then you'd
Push button.
push the button. And off he goes. Ta-da! This took
Into a
me,
wall.
hey, into a wall. This took me a lot longer than I would like to admit. I tried a Pez dispenser like I had, but it was different and it didn't work. So I tore it down and I had water streams going like zigzagging through. I'm like, this is horrible. And I tore that out, and then I made that Pez dispenser, and that one worked. And I think I'm happy. I'm happy with it. We'll just have to put up with the fact that sometimes there's a glitch in the system, until I can come up with a better solution.
This is the Matrix.
We could do like an activator, a powered activator rail, kick him out, push him up here, and then push a minecart into him or something like that. Or have a dispenser underneath it, do it the other way.
Maybe.
There'll be a way. Anyway, I'm very happy with that, and for the sake of my sanity and getting this episode out, I am going to have to end it there. So thanks everyone for watching. Looks like I'm standing on the villager's head here. Excellent. I'm gonna come join my people. Dear. So I've lost my marbles. I completely lost my marbles. I'm also recording this in the old screen resolution because that's how I started it. I think I do need to wear the golden armor next time because I have stuffed up by not setting the resolution properly. Ah, get out. So thanks everyone for watching. Thank you, Kiva, for coming to push buttons and brainstorm some
You're
ideas
welcome.
there. And remember,
How do we get out of here?
you don't. And remember, it's not dangerous. I didn't make it. See ya.